Now let's take a quick look at comparing Boolean variables. And now remember, a Boolean is something that holds a true or a false. And so we might, for example, use a Boolean variable. I've got my little comparison fun class set up here. I'll create a Boolean variable called error. And I'll set that equal to false to begin with. But if somewhere in our program we get to a point where we're getting an error of some sort, then we can check on that by setting that variable to true if we run into an error, and then we can say if error equals true, then we can print something like system.out.println. Sorry, there was an error. Okay, so in this case it's not going to print anything out because, oh see, made a mistake there. We can only have one equal sign to set, two equal sign to compare. And I made that error completely on purpose so you would get that point driven a little bit further. Yeah, right. Okay, so if we run this now, it's not going to do anything because there is a false in error and we're saying if error equals true. Well, if I set error equal to true, to begin with, then we'll get that message, sorry, there was an error. And we do that by saying, was there an error? Now, in Java, we can, we try to name these variables in such a way that, again, it kind of reads like a story. Because we can say, if error, and that error holds a true or a false. Now, again, in this situation, in order for this statement to be executed, we need the result of what's between the parentheses and the if statement to be true. So error holds a true. And we're saying if true equals true, and does true equal true? The answer is yes. So the result of this is a true. Now this is kind of a little tricky Java shortcut, but we do this type of thing all the time. We say if error, well that already holds a true or a false, so we don't necessarily need to say if true equals true, we can just say if error. And if we say if error, because it already holds a true or a false, then that's all we need. We don't need to compare it to anything because it only holds a true or a false. So if error equals true is in essence what this is saying. If error, if there's a true and error, maybe that's a better way of saying it, then we'll print, sorry, there was an error, and we get that printout because there's a true in the error variable. Well, we can also say false, there an error, and if we do this, then was there an error? No, that's false, and so it just skips over this line. So this is kind of a unique thing to Boolean variables that you'll see in Java programming. Now notice we didn't print anything out. It's kind of a unique thing we'll see in Java programming. Well, not just Java programming, but I'm saying in programming where we don't, because it does, it's exactly the same way in other languages too. I don't mean to tie it down strictly to Java. But in programming, Boolean variables are kind of special because they already hold a true or false. We can just write like this. And what we often do, and one of the other operators I want to talk about is a not. We can, remember in with numbers we can say not equal by doing an exclamation point and an equal sign. Well, if we want to say if there's not an error, then we set that variable up, and then we can just put a not out in the front of that statement and say, if there's not an error, then say no errors. Okay, so there's a false in that error variable, and if there is not an error, meaning error is false, or not true, I guess is a better way of saying it, because this is going to hold a true or false, and we're saying if it's not a true, meaning it is a false, then we're going to print this out. I feel like we've just done like a tongue twister for our brain, though, not just for our mouth. It's like for our brain. Whenever we get into this not logic, it becomes a little difficult to picture what's going on. But what we're saying there is, if it's not the situation that there is an error, okay, and in this case there isn't an error, and so we will print out that result. But we do this all the time. We could also do this by saying, if error is not equal to true. Okay, and that's accomplishing the exact same thing. It's just a different way of doing it. So we say no errors, because error is not equal to true. But the shortcut is to just say, if not error. All right, hopefully that makes sense. Spencer out.